Hi, this is Raxul and welcome back to another video of custom ROM review for your Redmi K20 Pro or MI90 Pro. As we know that the code name of this device is Raphael and Raphaelin, right? Okay, let's get going. Let's directly hop into settings, about phone, Android version, and here you can see the custom ROM is Project Elisa. And in this video we are going to do the review of Project Elisa, right, based on Android 12 Elisa version 1.2 device Raphael, and the Android security update is 5th December 2021, and SE Linux is enforcing, that is good, and the kernel is PARP kernel, right? This is Android 12, but here you don't get any customization here. As you can see, you don't have any customization here, right? Battery, you have the thermal profiles here. You can enable this gaming mode for your, but you don't have that 180Hz refresh mode, right? Touch sensitivity or something like that, you don't get that. Okay, so you have the live translation, right? You have the gesture. You have the gesture, but the three finger screenshot gesture is missing here, right? You don't see here. And the launcher is Pixel launcher right here. You can see you have at a glance, and you have the Pixel feature that you get in Pixel ROM, the Pixel feature you get here, right? Save the image, open, and you can view in your Google Photos or your gallery, right? We do have split screen, and you can copy the URL here from just from the recent application like this, right? You can share or copy the URL, right? This is useful. You can take screenshot, edit, crop, or something like that. And I have been using this custom ROM for 3 or 4 days, and the custom ROM is stable. You can definitely try this custom ROM. This is unofficial build, alright? In DRM info, let's check it out. Yes, this is good. You have security level L1, so you don't have any problem watching your video or playing games, right? Let's run the safety net, and the safety net is passed, right? Safety net request success, response signature validation success, basic integrity success, CTS profile success. And you get, let's see, Play Store settings, about, and you get device is certified out of the box, so there is no problem with your banking application. You can definitely use your banking application in this custom ROM without any issue, right? Now let's see the Geekbench score and the Antutu benchmark score. First, let's see the Geekbench score. Here you can see the single score is 718 and the multi score is 2393, right? Kernel is PARP, right? Now let's see the Antutu benchmark. Here is the Antutu benchmark score, 537065, right? This is not a bad score. This custom ROM use barb kernel, right? So you cannot expect much higher. Okay, how to install Project Elixir based on Android 12 OSS Bender based ROM, right? This custom ROM use Android 11 latest firmware of your device region, right? And Project Elixir comes with GApps build. You don't have to install GApps. Alright, so now, okay, so to install this custom ROM, we are going to wipe Dalvik cache system vendor data, swipe to wipe. Now select the Android 11 firmware, add to queue, select Project Elixir, now swipe to install. Okay, now if your phone is encrypted, you can go to wipe and format data type YES and that format and then reboot into system. Alright, but in my case, I am decrypted user, so I will need to flash disable force encryption. So I will flash DFE. Alright, okay, DFE has been installed. Now I will reboot into system. I don't need to format data because I am decrypted user. Alright, you only need to format your data if you are encrypted user. Alright, and that's pretty much it for this video. And if you guys enjoy watching this type of content, then please consider subscribing the channel and turn on the notification bell to get notified whenever I post new video in the future. And thank you for your amazing support. Take care, peace out, bye bye.